It's come to change our lives forever, building our nations and our homes, restoring sight to the blind, bringing hope to the hopeless. It goes beyond language barrier, 'cause it's a God carrier. It's our messenger angel to the rest of the world. It's Rhapsody. Our reality is giving our lives a meaning. Rhapsody. Our reality is giving our day a lift. Directing our path, enlightening our world. Rhapsody of reality. It has come to change our lives forever.
Coming up on Rhapsody of Realities.
Jesus defeated the devil on home ground.
On home ground.
So he has nowhere to parade himself as a powerful being, because wow, he was defeated where he was most respected.
Wow.
The southern African countries of Zambia and Namibia play host to your favorite devotional program this month of April.
Onawato.
Hello everyone from all over the world. Welcome to your favorite daily devotional.
Indeed, God's word is covering the world, even as the waters cover the seas. Join us every day as we travel on the word contained in the messenger angel this month of April.
Your believing will be seen in your actions.
Fulfilling your purpose on earth is God's dream.
Amen.
And have success at every stage of your life.
And that is the reason why Jesus Christ came on this earth.
Stay tuned.
Hello, and welcome to your favorite daily devotional program, The Rhapsody of Realities. And we are still coming to you from the great nation of Zambia. It has been such a beautiful time that we've had in Zambia.
Yes, Pastor Cholo, we've had a great time studying the Word of God in the Rhapsody of Realities.
Amazing. You know, and today we are looking at a very, very, very exciting subject by Pastor Chris, and it's titled Satan Fully Paralyzed.
Wow. I can't wait to delve into what Pastor is
subject,
saying to us.
What a subject. And I know it would be such an exciting subject, you know. And the opening scripture is the book of Luke, chapter number 10, verse 19. And it says, "Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you." Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You know, Pastor says there's no reason for any Christian to be afraid of the devil, for he is already defeated. Just looking at the opening scripture, he says, yes, God has given us power over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you.
That means we should not be afraid of anything.
Not at all.
Whether it's a weapon of mass destruction,
no,
or a weapon of single destruction,
disease,
failure,
wow,
we should not be afraid of anything, because we have been given authority. We have been given power to trample on any force that would set out to harm us.
Yes, and like Pastor has said in the opening place, in the opening segment of our devotional today, he has said there's no reason for any Christian to be afraid of the devil, for he is already defeated. And Pastor goes on to say, in Matthew 28, verse 18, Jesus said, "All power is given unto me in heaven and in earth." Notice, he said, all power.
Amen.
Not some power. Meaning there's none left for Satan.
Hallelujah. Oh,
praise God. Praise God. You know, I always hear a lot of people, some people rather say, Satan is powerful.
Oh, no.
This is a wrong construction.
Not at all.
You couldn't say he's powerful. And you know that's a compound word. To say powerful, you'd be implying he's full of power. But the Bible here is clear. Jesus said, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. All, meaning
There's everything. Nothing left for Satan.
Nothing left for Satan, like Pastor Chris has said. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And you know, Pastor goes on to say, he's been completely paralyzed and rendered helpless by Jesus. That is Satan. He's been completely paralyzed and rendered helpless by Jesus. The reason some people still live in fear of Satan and what they believe he can do against them is their ignorance of the scriptures.
Yes.
You know? And Pastor goes on to say, they unwittingly arrogate too much power to the devil, whereas he's been fully paralyzed.
Amen.
And if I was to add on to that, I would say fully paralyzed without anyone to ever lift him out of the paralysis.
Amen.
Wow.
And you know, that means there's nothing to fear.
Nothing to fear.
There's nothing to stop the Christian from living the life that God ordained for them to live.
Absolutely no reason.
Because there is no devil big enough to stop them.
No.
And you know, it reminds me of what Pastor says in many messages. He says, where is the devil now?
Where is the devil now? You know.
Amen.
He's been paralyzed. You know, and something interesting that Pastor brings in there is that a lot of people unwittingly arrogate too much power to the devil. Meaning, even some of the things that Satan has been able to do against their lives, it was because they gave him the place.
Mm-hmm.
It was because they gave him the place by way of their ignorance,
yes.
You know, and ignorance of the scriptures, you know. In truth, Satan knows even he himself, and many people that have found the truth of the word of God have come to discover that he's fully paralyzed.
Amen.
And that every child of God today is far, far higher than any principality and higher than the devil in the highest way that can ever be named. Because somebody would say, how do you say Christians are far higher than the devil? Question is, where is Jesus seated?
Yes.
Far above principality. And where are we seated? We are seated together with him.
Amen.
And so every Christian is far higher than any realm Satan will ever occupy.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
We continue reading the devotional, and Pastor Chris says to us, Jesus despoiled him and his demons.
Hallelujah.
He dispossessed them.
Wow.
Satan and his cohorts were stripped of their armor and rendered helpless by Jesus.
Hallelujah.
In Colossians 2:15, it says, having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them openly,
wow.
Triumphing over them in it.
Amazing.
You know, I like what Pastor says sometimes. He says Jesus defeated the devil on home ground.
On home ground.
So he has nowhere to parade himself as a powerful being, because
wow.
He was defeated where he was most respected.
Wow.
Praise God. We carry on reading. Jesus made an open show,
wow.
A spectacle of principalities and powers. What does this mean? It means he paraded Satan and his demons on the canvas as prisoners of war, wounded, beaten,
and paralyzed.
Wow.
Wow. What if everybody noticed this? And you see, as we read this like this, it may just sound like some exciting statement, but this is the whole truth of the word of God.
Amen.
You know, and you see, in that particular segment, Pastor shows us that Satan has been dispossessed.
Amen.
That means he has not just been defeated, but even the weapons he had were dispossessed of him.
Hallelujah.
They were stripped of him. For example, in the book of Hebrews chapter 2, verse 14, we are shown that he had the power of death. That means he doesn't have it anymore. He has been stripped even of death. Jesus now is the one holding the keys of death.
Amen.
Wow.
That is so exciting.
Amazing.
And you know, no matter how many demons they are,
They were paraded
as prisoners of war.
Wounded, beaten, and paralyzed.
That is so exciting.
Wow.
And that means there is nothing to stop you, child of God.
Wow.
And as you are watching this broadcast, just remember one thing. Many people give the devil too much attention.
Yes.
Don't give the devil undue attention.
Yes.
Pay attention to the word of God.
Yes.
Don't pay attention to what the devil is doing. No matter how many millions or billions or whatever myriads of demons he may send against you, you have much, much more power than him. For you are seated with Christ in the heavenly places. Far above all principalities and powers.
And you know, like you have said, Pastor Mappe, a lot of Christians like to allocate attention and credit to Satan, even, where it's not even necessary. You know,
You hear it in the way they testify. Satan came against me. And I thought, there's a mention of Satan at almost every point. Any little thing that happens, Satan is, they like to accredit too much to him. But the truth of the word of God is shining in our hearts today.
Amen.
He was wounded, beaten, and paralyzed. And we've never been informed that the paralysis is over because there's no one to end it. He's a paralyzed devil today. He will forever be a paralyzed devil. So praise God.
Hallelujah. So the devil is not a factor.
No, he's not.
And with those empowering and blessed thoughts, we're going to go on a short break. Stay tuned.
Through your favorite devotional program this month of April, you'll be inspired to take action. You have planned. You've set the targets for the year of favor. Now put action to your word as you join us every day this month of April. Don't miss a single day. It's the world's number one of its class. Thoughtfully laid out by inspiration. All assembled to create the grand design of your imagination and take you from dreams to realities. The Rhapsody of Reality's daily devotional, straight out of heaven.
Call now to place your order or log on to our website,